why I wanted to do this shoot and kind of have my freckles out and my curls and really show that is that it's about accepting yourself in a lot of ways. And I think COVID made a lot of people reflect on what's important in life and the people that are important in our lives and how we want to show up for ourselves. I definitely feel nude right now. Like I'm like doing this interview and I'm like, oh man, like, you know, all my beauty marks and all the things, and I think I might have a blemish or something. I just feel like completely raw, which usually is something that I feel the safe space for me to be that way would be to be, you know, acting in something where that's what the character requires. But as me, as Kat, I feel a little vulnerable. And that's something that I've been leaning more into throughout this process of trying to show up as me as much as I can. I've been actually prepping for this longer than I prep for makeup because I started a juice cleanse because I wanted to try out my theory that that beauty actually comes from the inside out when it comes to your health of your hair and of your skin. So I went on a juice cleanse and I did that for 3 days. So it's actually been the longest prep that I've ever had for a shoot, and it was no makeup and my curls. Hair has been such a great journey for me through this past year in quarantine. I've really embraced my curls, which is not something that I ever did before. I really relied heavily on straight wigs and things like that, and now I'm finding ways to have looser curls, tighter curls, softer curls, stronger curls. I feel like I'm almost a curl expert. I'm not quite there yet, but I would say conditioning my hair and really getting to know products and realizing that what works for me and what works for my skin type and what works for my hair type might not necessarily work for somebody else. I think the reason that my skin has been doing so well is that I've been wearing makeup sometimes, but when I'm home and I'm with my family and I'm with my dogs and, you know, I like my skin. I like to get to know my skin. I like to really nurture my skin. I love makeup and I definitely have gotten to know makeup better by having, you know, fun and maybe getting a little spruced up for a Zoom or two. But, you know, I think having a good skin regimen is really important and I didn't have one necessarily before this year. My new beauty routines, I've been going to sleep with red light therapy. So I've been using Vital Red Light and that's been kind of like a really amazing product. I never used to moisturize before I went to bed and now I do. I used to completely go to bed with my makeup on because, you know, I didn't have time to do anything. I was so busy. But now I actually take time to wind down from my day. And I know it's not necessarily a beauty hack, but my phone goes on Do Not Disturb at about 8:30. I allow my mind to completely relax before bed. I'm excited for my wrinkles. That's my life showing itself back at me. You know, those are my memories and all the times that if I can get, you know, a bit of like the crow's feet, and those are all the moments that somebody made me laugh, you know, and all the tickles I got in my life, you know, and I have these already, you know. This is my life, you know. Why would I want to freeze that? Especially for me as an actor, I don't want to be that kind of actress that never ages. I want to be able to be old one day and to enjoy it, you know. Especially, you know, a lot of people don't make it in this world. They don't get past age 30 or 40 or 50 or 60 or 70 or 80. And the fact that you've got that far is a blessing. And you should celebrate every single line